I ended up being offered the job of managing editor of the paper. I had had come up through the ranks, so to speak. I'd been made the city editor, but even when I was city editor, they allowed me to do my music column. But when they wanted me to become the managing editor, they weren't going to let me do my music column any longer. So I quit the paper instead of taking the managing editor's position. I literally turned down a $35,000 a year job so I could hang out at the studio and go to the line and get beer for tips. And it was without question the best decision I ever made in my life. I also started doing promo packs for bands, photographs, writing promo pieces, working as a freelance journalist in the music industry trades. And as a result of that, I ended up getting a job working with Pete Carr and his band LeBlanc Carr, and went out on the road with them as their road manager. We traveled quite a bit. We unfortunately were the opening act for Lynyrd Skynyrd in 1977, and we were opening the shows immediately prior to the plane crash that devastated that band. We had been booked for, I think, 29 of the 30 shows that that Skynyrd had on that tour, and the one show that we were not booked on was the Greenville, South Carolina show, the one immediately before the crash. And as a result, we were on the road in vans and cars driving to Baton Rouge, and they were flying to Baton Rouge when the plane crashed. That was a really obviously a bad situation, not just for Skynyrd, who lost members of their band, but also for us, because we had, like I said, we had 29 of the 30 dates for that leg of the tour booked, and then all of a sudden there are no more dates. This was October the 20th when it occurred, so we're going into Christmas season with no work. Most of the band members grabbed what jobs they could find, and we proceeded to make it through the first of the year and went back out with Journey and toured for throughout the up until the summer. The band came in the summer of 78 and went to Fame to record the second album. And in the process of recording the album, the band fell apart. And at that point in time, I went across town to Muscle Shoals Sound because I knew where I wanted to work. There wasn't any question in my mind that I wanted to work for Barry Beckett. And so I go over to Muscle Shoals Sound and I was hired and worked there for 2.5 years, so Barry decided to go to Nashville. Actually, no, I think it was 5.5 years. Anyway, I worked there for a long time. And in that course of that time, we did 2 Bob Dylan albums, and we did McGuinn Hillman, we did John Prine, we did Frankie Miller, which is a Scottish singer. We had quite a run there before he decided to go to Nashville and do country music.